coming to our showing of the best Christmas pageant ever. Luke, a few reminders.
Just remember to put your cell phones on silent and no flash photography during the show.
All right, we're going to start off the show with a quick joke to kind of get everybody in a happy, laughing mood. So it's a little Christmas theme, too. We changed it up. Hope you like it. Luke, did you hear about that Christmas-themed restaurant on the moon?
No, I didn't.
Ah, the food was great, but it had no atmosphere. Thank you. Thank you. It's going to be a good show, everybody. It's going to be a good show. Well, we'd like to start off with a prayer to St. Genesius. So if you look on the back of your playbooks, you can find it. And if you'd like to follow along with us, in the name of the Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit. Dear Genesius, according to a very ancient story, when you were still a pagan, you once ridiculed Christ while acting on stage. But like Saul on the road to Damascus, you were floored by Christ's powerful grace. You rose bearing witness to Jesus and died a great martyr's death. Intercede for your fellow actors before God, that they may faithfully and honestly perform their roles, and so help others to understand their role in life, and thus enabling them to attain their end in heaven. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, enjoy the show.
Sentiment, it seems to me.
It's a very practical sentiment. Charlie was black and blue all last year because he had to sit next to Leroy Herdman in school.
Is he the worst one? Leroy?
They're all the worst one.
Ralph's the biggest, so if Ralph gets
you... That doesn't make any difference. Gladys isn't big, but she's mean, and she's fast, and she bites.
Sorry I asked. Just stay away from all of them.
That's what I said. Stay away from them. Go to church.
I'm glad to hear you feel that way.
Why?
No arguments this year about the Christmas pageant.
I don't want to be a shepherd again.
Tell Mrs. Armstrong you want to be a wise man.
I don't want to be in it.
Everybody's in it. Think how I'd feel sitting there on Christmas Eve if my own children were in the pageant. Think how your father would feel. You'd feel terrible, wouldn't you, Bob?
Well, actually, I didn't plan to go. You know how crowded it always is. They can use my seat. Just stay at home, put on my bathrobe, relax. There's never anything different about the Christmas pageant.
There's going to be something different this year.
What?
Charlie's going to wear your bathrobe.
You just thought that up, Grace.
You should be Joseph. Elmer Hopkins will pay you $1 to be Joseph. Elmer's sick of being Joseph all the time just because his father's the minister. Nobody wants to be Joseph.
Nobody wants to be in it.
What are you going to be this year?
I'm always in the angel choir.
Why can't Charlie be in the angel choir?
Because I can't sing.
What I've heard in the past, that's not a serious drawback. The way in the manger always sounds to me like a closet full of mice.
What do you wear in the angel choir?
Bed sheets.
Oh boy, some choice. A bathrobe or a bed sheet. Come on, let's go watch TV.
You know, Mrs. Armstrong works very hard to give everyone a lovely experience.
Oh, Mom, Mrs. Armstrong just likes to run things.
You're right, of course. She directs Pageant, she runs Potluck Supper, she's chairman of the bazaar. I think Helen Armstrong would preach the sermon if anyone would let her.
Is that George Armstrong's wife?
Yes.
Maybe she'll try to manage the hospital. So that's where she is. I saw George at the drugstore and he told me his wife broke her leg this morning. She'll be in traction for 2 weeks and wait up till the first of the year.
The first of the year? Why, they'll have to pay up for Christmas.
She's in charge of Christmas?
Well, she's in charge of the pageant and she's in charge of the bazaar. I feel sorry for Helen, but who's going to do all those things?
Yes, Edna, I'll take care of the Christmas bazaar if you'll do the potluck supper. Ugh, I don't know what in the world we'll do about the Christmas pageant, though. Unless, how about Grace?
I just can't, Edna. I've got company all Christmas week. How about Grace?
How about Grace?
Hello? Grace?
Bob?
What?
I have to direct the Christmas pageant.
Does that mean I have to go?
Now, our Christmas pageant isn't what you'd call four-star entertainment. Mrs. Armstrong breaking her leg was the only unexpected thing to ever happen to it. It's always the same old Christmas story with the same old carols and the same old Mary and Joseph. And that's what my mother was stuck with. That and Mrs. Armstrong.
Tell you again, Grace, how important it is to give everyone a chance. Here's what I do. I always start with Mary, and I tell them we must choose our Mary carefully, because Mary was the mother of Jesus.
I know that, Helen.
Yes, and then I tell them about Joseph, that he was God's choice to be Jesus' father. That's how I explain that. Frankly, I don't ever
start with Mrs. Joseph. Armstrong was in traction. How can she talk on the phone if she's in traction?
What do you think traction is?
Like, when they put you to sleep?
No such luck. Beth, we need salt and pepper. And napkins.
And then I tell them there are no small parts, only small actors. Am I in the angel choir?
Save some for the rest of us, won't you, Charlie?
I'm hungry. Leroy heard him stole my lunch again.
How can you let him do that to you, day after day?
How can I stop him? Where's the chicken?
Grace, where's the chicken?
It's still in the oven.
I'll get it.
You'll have to get someone to push the baby angels on. Otherwise, they get in each other's way and bend their wings. Bob could do that! And he could keep an eye on the shepherds, too! Oh, another thing about the angel choir.
Helen, I have to go. There's someone at my door. Someone at my door, Helen. I'll talk to you later. Yes, I'm coming.
Hey, lady, can you give me some supper? I've not had a squirt in 3 days.
Well, for heaven's sake, it's you.
It's very lonely at the table.
Well, I guess Helen feels lonely at the hospital.
As long as the telephones are working.
I bet she told you about no small parts, only small actors.
And you need someone to push the baby angels on stage and make the shepherds shut up.
Yes, she suggested your father.
So, I mean, I have to go?
And Grace, don't use just anybody's baby for Jesus. Get a quiet one. Better yet, get two if you can. Then if one turns out to be fussy, you can always switch them.
My mother didn't pay much attention to Mrs. Armstrong. She said Mrs. Armstrong was just stuck in the hospital with nothing to do but think up problems, and that there weren't going to be any problems. Of course, Mother didn't count on the Herdmans. That was Charlie's fault.
Leroy, you give me back my lunch.
Sure, kid.
Here. Hey, you stole my dessert again.
How do you know?
Because it isn't here.
Oh yeah, what was it?
Two Twinkies.
Oh yeah, that's right, that's what it was.
Hey Leroy, you think it's so great stealing my dessert every day? And you know what? I don't care if you steal my dessert. I'll even give you my dessert. I get all the dessert I want in Sunday school.
Oh yeah? What kind of dessert?
All kinds. Chocolate cake and candy bars and cookies and Twinkies and Big Wheels. We get refreshments all the time. All we want.
You're a liar.
And ice cream and cupcakes and donuts.
Who gives it to
you? The minister.
Why? Is he crazy?
No, I think he's rich.
Sunday school? Huh.
To tell the Herdmans, and sure enough, the very next week, they were in Sunday school, just in time to hear about our Christmas pageant.
What's a pageant?
It's a play.
Like, on TV? What's it about?
Jesus?
Everything here is.
And Mary. Mostly, it's about Mary.
Who's Mary?
I am. Well, probably I am. I know the part.
This won't take very long if you all settle down. Today we're going to decide who will play the main roles in our Christmas pageant. But of course, everyone will have an important part to play. You know, Mrs. Armstrong always tells you, there are no small parts, only small actors. Isn't that what she always says?
That's what she always says, but she never says what it means.
Don't you know what it means?
I know what it means! It means that the short kids have to be in the front row of the angel choir, or else nobody can see them.
Well, not exactly. It really means that the littlest baby angel is just as important as Mary.
I don't think anyone is as important as Mary.
Well, naturally that's what you think, Alice. I think Jesus is more important.
I still think it means that the short kids have to be in the front row.
Come on, that's so stupid. Everyone is important. Mary, Jesus, and the short kids. Now, is everyone here? Beverly, will you just sit down the hall and see if anyone else is coming? Now, you little children will be our angels, so please remind your mothers that you'll need bed sheets, and children, the angel choir will need bed sheets too, and if any of you have old bathrobes at home. Now, let's make some room there for the Herdmans. Now, does anyone know what happened to Beverly?
Oh, I think she went home. I think she got sick.
Did she say she was sick?
Well, she just left. All I did was, I just said, "Hi, Beverly!" And she left.
I see. Well, someone please tell Beverly about the rehearsals? The next 4 Wednesdays after school plan to be here for everyone.
What if we get sick?
You won't get sick. Of course, Mary and Joseph must absolutely come to every rehearsal.
What if they get sick?
They won't get sick either, Elmer.
Well, Beverly got sick and we didn't even start yet.
We don't know that Beverly got sick. Now, I want you to think about Mary. We all know what kind of person Mary was. She was quiet and gentle and kind. And the girl who plays Mary should try to be that kind of person. Who would like to volunteer? Did you have a question, Imogene?
No. I want to be Mary. And Ralph, right there, he wants to be Joseph.
Yeah, right.
Oh, well, I'll just make a list of volunteers for these parts, and then we'll all decide who it should be. Ralph Herdman. Now, who else would like to volunteer? Did you raise your hand, Elmer?
Nope.
Just raise your hands, please. Any volunteers? Any of you shepherds? Very well, then. Ralph Herdman will be our Joseph. Now, Imogene has volunteered to be Mary. I'll just write that down. What other names can I put on my list? Alice, don't you want to volunteer?
No, I don't want to.
I'll be Mary.
Shut up, Gladys. I'm already Mary.
You can be a wise man.
Well, the wise men are usually boys. Of course, they don't have to be, and we could...
I'll be a wise
man! Me too.
God, you want to be a wise man? Raise your hand.
What's a wise man?
Just raise your hand.
What's left to be? Some angel. I'll be that. What is that?
It's the angel of the Lord who delivers the good news to the shepherds. There we do have some volunteers after all. Yes, Hobie, would you like to be a wise man?
No, I just wanted to say I can't be a shepherd. We're going to Philadelphia.
Why didn't you say so before?
I just remembered.
My mother doesn't want me to be a shepherd.
Why not?
I don't know. She just said, don't be a shepherd.
I'm not going to be a shepherd.
Oh, yes, you are. What's the matter with all of you?
I don't want to be a shepherd. Gladys Hardman hits too hard.
Why? Gladys isn't going to hit anybody. The angel of the Lord just visits the shepherds in the fields and tells them Jesus is born.
It hits them.
That's ridiculous, Elmer, and I don't want to hear another word of it from anyone. No shepherds may quit or get sick. Now, that's all for today, boys and girls, and you can go. But I expect to see everyone here on Wednesday at 6:30. Why in the world didn't you volunteer?
I don't know.
You don't know? Alice, I expected you to volunteer. Don't you want to be Mary?
Mrs. Bradley!
Oh, come on, Alice.
I don't know. I didn't dare raise my hand. Imogene would have killed me. She said, I'm going to be Mary in this play. And I said, I'm always Mary in the Christmas pageant. And she said, fine then. Go ahead, and next spring when the pussy willows come out, I'll stick one so far down your ear that no one will be able to reach it. And it'll sprout and grow and grow, and you'll have a pussy willow bush growing out your ear for the rest of your life.
You know she wouldn't do that.
Oh, yes, she would. The Hermans will do anything. You just wait and see. They'll do something terrible and ruin the whole show. It's all your mother's fault.
Somehow. How else would the six of them end up in a Christmas pageant when they ought to be in jail?
Vera? Irma Shlocum. I heard that Imogene Herdman is going to be Mary in the Christmas pageant and I... Is that a fact? All six of them. Vera, I live next door to that outfit and I would rather live next door to a zoo. Has Grace gone crazy?
Where did they come from? Who let them in? Imogene Herdman? What kind of a child is that? To be Mary, the mother of Jesus. Where was Reverend Hopkins? I'd like to know. He was what? Visiting shut-ins? Well, I'm shut in. He wasn't visiting me.
I say tell the truth and lock up the silver. Grab the collection before they clean them out. I said,
if I'd been up and around, this never would have happened.
Well, let me tell you.
Don't tell me. I'm on your side. Car's over there.
Helen Armstrong is not the only woman alive who can run a Christmas pageant. I made up my mind just to do the best I could in those circumstances, but now I'm going to make this the best Christmas pageant ever, and I'm going to do the Herdmans. After all, they raise their hands when no one else did, and I don't care.
Good for you, Grace. Car's over there.
And you're going to help me.
What's that mean?
You have to go.
Anyway,
what's an inn?
It's like a motel where people go to spend the night.
What people? Jesus?
Oh, honestly, Jesus wasn't even born yet. Mary and Joseph went there.
Why?
To pay their taxes.
At a motel?
Shut up, Ollie. Everybody shut up. I want to hear her. Begin at the beginning.
The beginning?
The beginning of the play. What happens first?
Imogene, this is a Christmas story from the Bible. Haven't you heard the Christmas story from the Bible? Oh, well, that's what this pageant is, so I'd better read it to you.
Oh, my.
I don't believe that to you, that they never even heard the Christmas story.
Why not? They don't even know what a Bible is. And they never went to church until your dumb brother told them we got refreshments. Now we have to waste all our time for nothing.
All right, now. There went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and Joseph went up from Galilee with Mary, his wife, being great with child.
Pregnant! She was pregnant!
Okay, now that's enough. We all know Mary was pregnant. And it came to pass when they were there that the day should be accomplished, that she should be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son.
I don't think it's very nice to say Mary was pregnant.
Well, she was.
Your mother should say Mary was pregnant. It's better to say great with child. I'm not supposed to talk about people being pregnant, especially at church.
And wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there's no room for them in the inn.
My God, they didn't have room for Jesus?
Well, they didn't know the baby was Jesus.
Didn't Mary know? Didn't he know? It was not with Joseph that you didn't tell him you're pregnant and everything.
What's a manger? Some kind of bed?
Well, they didn't have a bed in the barn, so Mary had to use whatever there was. What would you do if you had a new baby and no bed to put the baby in?
We put Gladys in a bureau drawer.
Oh, well, there you are. You didn't have a bed for Gladys, so you had to use something else.
Oh, no, we had a bed. Just that Ollie, he was in it and he didn't want to get out because he didn't really like Gladys that much.
Hey, everybody didn't like Gladys.
That was pretty smart of Ollie not to like Gladys right off the bat.
Anyway, a manger is a wooden feeding trough for animals.
What were the wadded up clothes?
The what?
It said in there, she wrapped him in wadded up clothes.
Swaddling clothes. People used to wrap babies up very tightly in big pieces of material to make them feel cozy.
They say they tie him up and put him in a feed box? Where was the child welfare? The child welfare is at our house every 5 minutes.
There was no child welfare in Bethlehem.
I'll say there wasn't.
The shepherds watched over their flocks by night, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of
Shazam!
What?
Out of the black night with horrible vengeance, the mighty Marvo!
I don't know what you're talking about, Gladys.
The mighty Marvo, in Amazing Comics. Out of the black night with horrible vengeance!
This is the angel of
the Lord who visits the shepherds.
Out of nowhere, right? In the black night, right?
Well, in a way.
Shazam.
Now, when Jesus was born, they came wise men from the east, bringing gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh.
What's that?
They were special gifts, spices and precious oils.
Oil? What kind of present is oil? We get better presents than that from the welfare.
Were they the welfare? The wise men?
They were kings and they were sent.
Well, it's about time somebody important showed up. They're kings and get the baby out of the barn until the innkeeper were to get off.
They were sent by Herod, who was... Well, he was the main king, and he wanted to find Jesus and have him put to death.
My God, he just got born. They're going to kill a baby?
Who's Herod in this play?
Herod isn't in the play.
He's out to kill the baby? He's not even in the play?
Somebody better be Herod. Let Charlie be Herod. And he says, go give me that baby. And then they say, okay, because he's a king and all.
Yeah, but then they don't do it. They go back and get Herod.
Going to be Herod.
No one is going to be Herod.
No. Joseph gets the shepherds together, and they go wipe out Herod.
See? They're gonna put one in, and it's gonna be me,
forget,
and I'll get killed.
Forget about Herod. There is no Herod.
And I don't have the baby until the fight's over.
Yeah. Somebody ought to fix that innkeeper. Gladys, take care of the innkeeper.
I can't. I'm an angel.
Hang around out in the barn, I'd go get a room.
She said there wasn't any room.
Then I'd throw somebody out. I'd say, I've got this baby, and it's the middle of winter, so either get out and move over.
I go after old Herod.
I'd send the angel after him. She could just point a little electric finger and then turn them to a pile of ashes.
Yeah.
What's the name of this play? She never said.
Christmas Pageant.
That's no name. That's what it is.
I know a name. I know a name. We'll call it Revenge at Bethlehem.
Yeah.
Revenge at Bethlehem? The Herdmans thought the Christmas story came right out of the FBI files. At least they picked the right villain. It was Herod they wanted to gang up on, and not the baby Jesus. But the baby Jesus quit the pageant anyways. It was supposed to be Eugene Slocum, but Mrs. Slocum said she wasn't going to let Imogene Herdman get her hands on him. So we didn't have a baby Jesus, and that upset my mother. She kept trying to scratch up a baby, even at the last rehearsal. In that book. It's like a diary. It is not. It's all about the Herdmans. Gladys curses and swears all the times. Ralph talks about sexy things. Mrs. Bradley called Mary pregnant. Imogene drinks communion wine all the time. No, she doesn't. It's grape juice.
I don't care what it is. She drinks it. I've seen it 3 times with her mouth all purple. And they steal, too. If you shake the piggy bank, it doesn't make a sound. Because they took all the pennies out of it.
And every time you go into the ladies' room, the air is all blue. Imogene Herdman is sitting there in her Mary costume, smoking cigars.
And you wrote all this down, what for?
For my mother, and Reverend Hopkins, and the Ladies' Aid Society. Anyone else who wants to know what happened when the whole Christmas pageant turns out to be a big mess.
All right, everyone, let's get quiet. Matt, will you now squeeze some here so we can get started? Now, this is our last rehearsal, and we're going.
Grace, I just wanted to let you know that we're all in the kitchen making applesauce cake, so we'll try not to bother you, since I guess this is your dress rehearsal?
It's supposed to be. Edna, didn't I hear that your niece had a baby a month or so ago? A little girl?
Yes, she's 5 weeks old and just...
Well, I wonder how it'd be if I were to call her up and ask if we could borrow...
Grace, no. I could make up some lie and tell you that the baby's sick or cranky or something, but the truth is that she's perfectly healthy and happy and beautiful. And we all want her to stay that way. So we're certainly not going to hand her over to Imogene Herdman. Sorry, Grace.
Mrs. Bradley, you can have my baby brother for Jesus.
I didn't know you had a new baby, David.
Well, he's not new. He's like 4 years old, but he's double-jointed and probably scrunch up.
Well, I don't think...
I'll guess the baby.
And how will you do that?
There's only 2 or 3 babies and carriages outside the supermarket. I'll get one of them.
Imogene, you can't just take somebody's baby. I guess we'll just use a doll.
Yeah, that's better anyways. Doll can't bite you.
And Imogene, you know Mary doesn't wear earrings.
I have to wear these. I got my ears pierced, and if I don't keep something, then they'll grow together.
Well, they won't grow together in an hour and a half. What'd the doctor tell you to do?
What doctor?
Well, who pierced your ears?
Gladys.
I bet she did it with an ice pick. Imogene's ears will probably turn black.
Well, we'll just find something smaller now. Is that your costume? Is that what you're going to wear? You're all supposed to have your costumes on today.
But I can't find my halo.
My wings are all bent.
Janet's got my robe.
My mom says that we don't have any white sheets. Can I wear a sheet with balloons on it?
I don't have a costume. I've never been a shepherd before.
You have to wear your father's bathrobe. That's what I have to do.
He hasn't got a bathroom.
Well, what does he hang around the house in?
His underwear. What else?
All right, now just pretend you're wearing your costumes.
We're going through the whole thing?
Yes, of course. But first, I want you to enter the city, so if you'll all go where you're supposed to be, and we'll start with the shepherd. Just read the last few words, Maxine.
Shepherds keeping watch over their flocks by night.
Music, shepherds.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them.
Shazam!
No, Gladys.
Out of the black night.
No. Come on, Maxine.
A multitude of heavenly hosts.
Music. Angels. Music. Wise men.
I got the baby here. Don't touch him. I named him Jesus.
No, you don't say anything. Mary doesn't say anything. Mary Joseph.
Just
make a lovely picture for us all to look at while we think about Christmas and what it means. Now. Take the doll back.
I never get to say anything. Some angel tells me what to call the baby. I'm an amazing Bill.
Oh, what a terrible thing to say.
What angel was that anyway? There's angels all over this place. Was that Gladys?
No, Gladys delivers the good news to the shepherds.
Yeah. Unto you, a child is born! Unto me, not them, me. I'm the one who had the baby.
No, that just means Jesus belongs to everybody. Unto all of us, a child is born.
Why did they let Mary name her own baby? What did the angel do? Just walk up and say, name him Jesus.
Yes.
I know what the angel said. She said, for his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
My God, you're never gonna have first grade kids write all that.
I pulled back the
Mrs. Bradley, what should I do? Should I start over?
5 minutes, Maxine. 5 minutes!
We never did start over, and we never did make it through the whole thing. The 5 minutes turned into 15 minutes, and Imogene Herdman spent the whole time in the ladies' room, smoking cigars.
Mrs. McCarthy walked in and saw all the smoke and called the fire department, and they came right away.
Fire! There's a fire!
Church. Then they dragged a hose through the whole building looking for a fire to put out. But the only one they found was in the kitchen. All the applesauce cake had burned up. Of course, that made all the ladies mad. And Mrs. McCarthy was mad. And my mother was mad.
Why in the world did you call the fire department over a little smoke?
It was a lot of smoke. There was thick smoke everywhere.
There couldn't have been. You just got excited. And now look, the church is full of firemen, and the streets are full of baby angels crying, and shepherds climbing all over fire trucks in the whole neighborhood. Didn't you know it was cigar smoke?
No, I didn't know it was cigar smoke. I didn't expect to find cigar smoke in the ladies' room of the church. And the whole Ladies' Aid Society was mad, and Alice Wendelkin's mother was mad, and Reverend Hopkins just didn't know what to think.
I've been on the telephone all day, and I can't make heads or tails of it. Some people say they set fire to the ladies' room. Some people say they set fire to the kitchen. Farrah Wendelkin says all they do is talk about sex and underwear.
That was Toby Clark talking about underwear. If they didn't set fire to anything, the only fires in the kitchen were the applesauce cake burned up.
Well, the whole church is in an uproar. I don't know. Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me, but I don't think he meant the Herdmans. Grace, don't you think we should cancel the pageant?
I'll bet that was Helen Armstrong's idea.
We can blame it on the fire. Makes a good excuse.
I'll bet that was Edna McCarthy's idea.
Everyone seems to think it's gonna be,
disaster? Well, they're wrong. It's going to be the best Christmas pageant we ever had.
But Grace, I don't think anyone will come to see it.
I didn't think so either, and neither did Charlie, but we were wrong. On Christmas Eve, the church was jammed full. Everybody came to see what the Herdmans would do.
Watch your step. Wait till I turn the lights on.
Can't even see where I'm going. No, what in the world do you expect me to do with this thing?
Thought it might look like a palm tree. I see now that it doesn't. I won't have any idea what's going to happen tonight. We've never gone through the whole thing once, and the Herdmans still think it's some type of spy story. I think this may be the first Christmas pageant in history where Joseph and the wife can get a fight and Mary runs off with a baby. Where are the kids?
All the kids in the world are down in the basement putting on bed sheets.
I mean, our kids.
We're here.
Well, it's getting late. Go get your costumes on.
It's going to be just awful, you know. They look like trick-or-treat, all fastened together with safety pins, wearing moldy old sneakers. Mary and Joseph, I mean, they look like refugees or something.
Well, that's what they were, Mary and Joseph. They were refugees. They were a long way from home, didn't have any place to stay, didn't know anyone. They're probably cold and hungry and tired and messy.
I don't know about cold and hungry, but they sure are messy.
Oh dear, do you think I should?
I think you worry too much. I'm going to push baby angels on stage. I'm going to hand out shepherd's crooks and then push them on stage. And when do I do all that?
Just follow the script.
Baby angels, shepherds, wise men. They seem to stay here when the fire engines come in.
Oh.
Just kidding.
you and Alice please help the baby angels? I just want to see how you all look. Gladys, where's your halo?
Oh, our cat buried it. Listen, I think I ought to say something besides the baby cane. I mean, why else would they all get up and tear off after some baby they don't even know? I ought to tell them it's Jesus, and I ought to tell them where he is.
No, you just say, under you, a child is born, and that's it. Now let's all go backstage and be quiet while people are coming. And good luck.
Mrs. Bradley, actors don't say good luck. Actors say break a leg.
Yes, for those of you who don't know, break a leg is just a theatrical saying. It doesn't really mean break a leg, yours or anyone else's. And Imogene, try to remember that that is a baby. And for tonight anyways, it's the baby Jesus.
There went out a decree that all the world should be taxed. So Joseph went into Bethlehem with Mary his wife, who was great with child. And while they were there, she brought forth her firstborn son and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Over their flocks by night. Him, bringing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Oh, look, they look awful too. And what's that Leroy's got?
It's a ham.
A ham? I bet they stole it.
No, I think it's the one from their welfare basket.
You mean it's their own ham?
They must really hate ham. Well, even if they hate ham, it's the only thing they gave away in their whole life.
Being warned in a dream that they should not return to their own land, the wise men departed another way. The shepherds also departed, praising God for all they had seen and heard. But Mary kept all of these things and pondered them in her heart.
Christmas pageant ever. And I don't know why, but for some reason, I think it was them. Could that be?
Well, I always get weepy about the Christmas pageant. I think it's the children and the carols and all. But you're right, this was the best one. It should have been the worst.
There was just something different.
Well, the angel Lord was different.
Yes, but I like that. Had lots of spirit. Sometimes you can't even hear the angel of the Lord. I must find Grace and tell her.
I just wish now I'd let her use baby Eugene to be the baby Jesus.
Who was the baby Jesus?
Why, it was a doll.
No, Irma, that was no doll.
Well, it did seem real.
It did seem real, as if it might have happened just that way. We all thought the Christmas pageant was about Jesus, but that was only part of it. It was about a new baby and his mother and father who were in a whole lot of trouble. No money, no place to go, no one they knew, no doctor. And then, arriving from the East, like my uncle from New Jersey, some rich friends. But because of the Herdmans, it was a whole new story. Imogene burping the baby and the wise men bringing such a sensible present. After all, you can't eat frankincense. Even Gladys, he's in the barn, go see him! So the shepherds didn't have to stumble around all over the countryside. But I guess it wasn't like that for Imogene. For her, the Christmas pageant turned out to be all wonder and mystery. As if she finally caught on to what Christmas was really about. When it was over, we had a party in the basement, but the Herdmans didn't stay. They didn't have any cocoa, and they didn't walk off with all the cookies. They wouldn't even take their candy canes.
Guess that's about it. You kids left downstairs?
No, everyone's gone. You know you have your bathrobe on. You aren't going to wear it, are you?
Why not? Maybe people will think I was a shepherd. Would mind being taken as a shepherd in this Christmas pageant?
Yes, you would. When it was over, some lady came up and hugged me because I was a shepherd. Where should I put this ham?
It's the Herdmans, but they wouldn't take it back. Leroy said it's a present. You don't take back a present.
They must really hate ham.
You and Alice Wendelkin.
What about the lights?
They're on a timer. They'll go off at midnight.
It's not far away. It's almost Christmas.
Almost Christmas, kids.
Almost Christmas, Charlie.
And it came to pass in the days of.
And there were shepherds abiding, a multitude praising God.
I bring you good tidings of great joy.